Two of the best smartphones you can buy on Verizon Wireless come from the same manufacturer, but their similarities are only software deep. I'm Michael Fisher with Pocketnow, and if you're torn between high-end Motorolas on America's largest network, join us for DROID Turbo versus Moto X. Now, DROID Turbo might sound like your typical macho marketing term, and it is, but it's also not a bad name when comparing hardware against the latest Moto X. Because this comparison is largely about specs, let's get these numbers out of the way first. Where the Moto X packs a 13-megapixel camera, the Turbo kicks its own shooter up to 21 megapixels. The Moto X display is 1080p, or full HD, while the Turbo's is the sharper quad HD. The Turbo's processor is newer and faster, and it offers half again as much RAM and a larger internal storage option. Finally, the Turbo brings faster charging, wireless charging, and its battery is 70% larger. Some people have said that the DROID Turbo is what the Moto X should have been, and just looking at the side-by-side details, well, we can see why some people would say that. There's also a big aesthetic gulf between these phones, though, and here the comparison is a little less cut and dry. Each offers a choice of casing options, but the Turbo stops at two, metallized glass weave or ballistic nylon. While you can dress up the Moto X in everything from plastic to leather to bamboo, and pick your own key color and trim color while you're at it. The X is also lighter and thinner than the Turbo in every configuration, and its metal trim and buttons give it a more expensive look and feel overall, even though it's the cheaper of the two. So the X is the one I'd pick for a nice dinner. With the DROID's advertised water resistance and more rugged build, that's the one I'd prefer for a hiking or wall climbing date. There's less to talk about on the software side, at least in terms of differences, because for the second year in a row, Motorola has baked the very best of the Moto X into the new DROID. On each one, you can reach for the phone to trigger the Moto display, preview notifications without unlocking, send and receive text messages via dictation, and interact with the software without ever touching it.
Hello, Moto.
The chief difference in software is on the home screen. Here, the Moto X gives you what many call a pure Android experience. It uses the Nexus launcher, so Google Now is permanently anchored to the left of home base, and it employs the more adaptable soft keys at the bottom. The Turbo uses capacitive buttons instead, which frees up screen real estate but also comes across as somewhat antiquated. And like previous DROIDs, its launcher layout puts your starting point on the leftmost home screen. Google Now is down at the bottom once again. There's even a circular time and weather widget that recalls the DROIDs of generations past. Of course, this being Verizon, there's also a fair helping of carrier bloatware, from the useful to the inane. You can probably do without VZ Navigator and My Info Zone, but DROID Zap has some interesting potential if you share a lot of photos. More on this in the full review. For our purposes, the software package across phones is nearly identical. Whether they receive Android updates at the same time or not is another question, which only time and After the Buzz re-reviews will answer. Our second biggest complaint about the Moto X when we reviewed it was the lackluster camera. And while the DROID Turbo definitely improves on that shooter in resolution and processing, the difference isn't as big as you might expect in the end results. First off, yes, images are definitely crisper in the full-res shots from the Turbo. But it shoots in 15.5 megapixels by default, presumably to offer widescreen shots that look better in the viewfinder. And here, it's tougher to make out a significant difference. You can see some changes in vibrance and contrast, with the Turbo doing slightly better in both cases, and the Turbo's also much more likely to activate its HDR setting in automatic mode. The DROID also takes longer to capture shots, by a second or so, but it's easier to hold steady while you do because of its added mass. Probably the most dramatic change is in low light, a hugely important category for anyone who spends time at the pub or the club. While the Turbo's results aren't spectacular, they're at least better than the X's. And really, that's good shorthand for all the camera improvements. The Turbo's no quantum leap, but it's certainly an upgrade. We've got more still video and selfie captures over at pocketnow.com. How about performance? Well, we kicked off this comparison with a boatload of specs, pretty much all of them favoring the DROID Turbo. And in some cases, those specs do translate to a better experience on the brawnier device. First off is battery life. We're still in the process of breaking in the Turbo's battery, so impressions of overall endurance will have to wait. But you don't have to go far to beat the Moto X in this game. If our second biggest complaint was its camera, our biggest complaint was definitely its battery life. And the Turbo absolutely holds up better, delivering about an hour more of screen on time in our testing so far. It's the Droid's quick charge ability that really seals this one, though. Being able to charge at high speed with the turbocharger makes it much more compelling as a travel smartphone. Since we're on two different networks here, we didn't compare call quality, but we can say that the addition of a fifth microphone to the Turbo certainly hasn't hurt its Crystal Talk noise suppression. If you're a conference call kind of guy or gal, the Moto X speakerphone is a little louder than the one on the Turbo. Whether this is due to added waterproofing on the Droid or just differences in design is tough to say, but at least they're both front-firing, which is always a win. In normal use, you're not going to notice the difference in guts too much. Yes, the Turbo's processor is faster, and it has more RAM, and of course that Quad HD display packs a hell of a lot more pixels, but really, that extra storage space is a lot more practical than either of those details, especially as you load it with more and more camcorder video and graphics-intensive games over the months. So the Turbo is likely to age more gracefully over time, thanks to all that supercharged hardware. Again, contingent on timely Android updates. Looking at you, Verizon. So the DROID Turbo being the phone the Moto X should have been, that's overstating the case somewhat. It's more accurately described as the Moto X with a jetpack and some extra armor strapped to it. You'll pay at least $100 more for those accoutrements, and for now you'll also have to be on Verizon to appreciate them. You'll also have to be cool with giving up the better, tailor-made looks of the Moto X. But if you're a more pragmatic Verizon customer, shopping for a get-things-done Android, and you don't care much about cosmetics or customization, the DROID Turbo is probably the better buy overall. Remember everyone, this isn't the official review. We'll have much more detail and more in-depth thoughts in our full review of the DROID Turbo coming the first week of November. If you can't wait that long, we'll have the DROID Turbo in hand in our October 30th episode of the Pocketnow Weekly, so tune in for that over at pocketnow.com and we'll be answering your questions live on the air. Till next time, this has been Michael Fisher with Pocketnow, Captain Two Phones on Twitter, reminding you that sometimes the bombastic name is the right one. We'll see you next time.